Good morning. Last class we have compared the stability of BU2-EN and BU2-1-EN on the basis of hyperconjugation interaction, and in this class we are comparing the stability or the reactivity of toluene, ethyl benzene, isopropyl benzene and tertiary butyl benzene. So we are comparing the stability of toluene. Toluene means methyl benzene, because in the ring there is a methyl group, that is toluene. Then we are taking ethyl benzene, isopropyl benzene and tertiary butyl benzene. Look at it here. Toluene, ethyl benzene, isopropyl benzene and tertiary butyl benzene. What is toluene? Toluene means methyl benzene. So here it is benzene, here it is CH3 group. This is methyl benzene, or it is called toluene, methyl benzene. Next one is ethyl benzene. Ethyl benzene means what is that? Instead of methyl group, here it will be CH2CH3, ethyl group, ethyl benzene. Next one is isopropyl benzene. What do you mean by isopropyl benzene? Look at it here. Here CH2CH3. In isopropyl benzene, one more hydrogen atom, here it is CH2, one hydrogen atom will be replaced by CH3 group. So here it will be this is CH2CH3. Isopropyl benzene means one hydrogen atom will be replaced by CH3. Clear? Here this is methyl benzene, CH3. Ethyl benzene, what do you mean by ethyl benzene? From CH3, one hydrogen atom is replaced by a CH3 group. So here it will become CH2 and one hydrogen atom will be replaced by a CH3 group. That is ethyl benzene. What do you mean by isopropyl benzene? One more hydrogen atom is replaced by methyl group. So what is that? CH3, then here it will become CH and CH3. Okay, CH3. Become CH3. And what do you mean by tertiary butyl benzene? The last hydrogen atom, this hydrogen atom also replaced by another methyl group. So tertiary butyl benzene, look at the structure. Here it is like this. No, here it is only C. Here it is CH3. And here it is CH3. And here is also CH3. So we are comparing, this is toluene or methyl benzene, ethyl benzene. This is isopropyl benzene. And this one is tertiary butyl benzene, on the basis of the hyperconjugation interaction. Look at here. Here this is double bonded carbon. This is a double bond, and this carbon, that means here is a carbon. You know that this is benzene ring, here is a carbon. This carbon attached to this carbon though, so this is alpha carbon, because carbon which is attached to a double bonded carbon. This carbon is alpha carbon. So in this alpha carbon, in toluene, how many alpha hydrogen atoms are there? 1, 2, 3 alpha hydrogen atoms are there. Okay, so keep it in mind, this is the double bonded carbon. In that carbon there is a carbon. This carbon is a alpha carbon. In this alpha carbon there are 3 hydrogen atoms. And therefore, how many alpha hydrogen atoms are there? 3 alpha hydrogen atoms are there. Now let us go through the canonical forms which we are getting through hyperconjugation interaction. Look at it here. This bond, you can take this bond. This bond is shifting to here. Correct? Then what will happen to this bond? This bond is moving to this carbon. Keep it carefully. Listen very carefully. First canonical form we are getting. CH bond. This bond breaks from hydrogen. Okay, breaks from hydrogen and it is moving to here. Here it will become a double bond. Then this double bond is migrating to this carbon. So you get the first canonical form like this. Okay, here it will become double bond C. And here there is no bond, only H plus. Here is H and here is also H. Correct? Like this. And since this pair of electron, a bond means a pair of electron, this bond is shifting to this carbon. So this carbon is getting a pair of electron and a negative charge. This bond, no change. In the next structure, you can see that this pair of electron will be shifted between these two carbon. Then what will happen to this double bond? This double bond will be moved to here. So you get the next structure, resonance structure like this. This is resonance structure like this. Here it is C and here it is H. Here is H and here is H plus. And since this bond is shifting between these two carbon, here it will become a double bond. Since this pair of electron is moving to this carbon is getting a pair of and a negative charge, and this bond remains as it is. And in the next structure, you can see that next canonical form, it will be shifted to here. So what will happen? This pair of electron, this will be moved to this carbon. You get a structure like this. Okay, here it is like this. And double bond C, here it is H, H, and here it is H plus. And look at here, here it is double bond. And since this pair of moving here, here is a double bond. This pair of electron is moving to this carbon. Here is a pair of electron and a negative charge. So with one hydrogen, the first hydrogen, with one hydrogen, how many canonical forms? 1, 2, 3 form canonical forms we are getting. Similarly, this second hydrogen also, third hydrogen also can make 3, 3, 3. So how many total, how many canonical forms are available for toluene? 9. Keep it in mind, this is a ring. Okay, when first hydrogen atom is undergoing hyperconjugation interaction, how many forms are possible? 1, 2, 3. Now, when the second hydrogen atom is undergoing hyperconjugation interaction, how many forms again we will get? 3. Even third hydrogen atom also will give 3. Total, how many forms are available? Resonance or hyperconjugate interactions are hyperconjugative interactions are possible for toluene. 9 hyperconjugative interactions are possible. How it is that one hydrogen can make 3 interactions, second hydrogen also will make 3, and the third hydrogen will also make 3. Total, how many interactions are possible? 9. Keep it in mind, toluene can make 9 hyperconjugative interactions. Okay. What do you mean by second? Okay, look at here. What do you mean by second hydrogen atom? Okay, first hydrogen. Now, second hydrogen, this will move to here. So, what will happen? Here it will become H plus and you get a double bond. And again, this is the same thing will be repeated due to the second one. What do you mean by third hydrogen atom? This bond is shifting to here. So it will be shifted to here. Here it will become H plus and here it will double bond. And the same, we will get 3 hyperconjugative interaction. Total 9. Okay, for toluene. Now let us see the hyperconjugative interactions for ethyl benzene. The second one is ethyl benzene. CH2CH3 means what is that? CHH. Correct? So look at here. Here it is. Okay. Now in ethyl benzene, how many alpha hydrogen atoms are there? This is alpha carbon. Only 2. In methyl benzene or toluene, how many were there? 3 alpha hydrogen atoms. Total how many interactions? 9. Methyl benzene, here it is. This is our methyl benzene or toluene. How many interactions are possible? 9 interactions are possible. Hyperconjugative interactions are possible. Now here how many alpha hydrogen atoms are there? 2. So what is that? This bond will be shifted to here. It will go there. Okay. So in the first hydrogen atom will give 3 hyperconjugative interactions or 3 canonical forms, and the second hydrogen atom will also give 3. Total how many? 6 hyperconjugative interactions. Okay. In ethyl benzene. Now in isopropyl benzene. This is isopropyl benzene. This one is alpha carbon. CH means there is only one hydrogen. Only one alpha hydrogen is present in isopropyl benzene. This is all the only one alpha hydrogen. So how many? This is only one interaction is possible, and how many forms are available? That means only one alpha hydrogen atoms are involving, and we get 3 hyperconjugative interactions, 3 canonical forms. And when you come to tertiary butyl benzene, in tertiary butyl benzene, there is no alpha hydrogen and it will not give any hyperconjugative interaction. Here hyperconjugative interaction is 0 because there is no alpha hydrogen. It cannot undergo hyperconjugation interaction. Therefore, its hyperconjugation interaction is 0. Here it is 3, and here it is 6, and here it is 9. So, based on hyperconjugative interactions, we know that more the number of alpha hydrogen atoms, more will be the hyperconjugation interaction. More is the hyperconjugation interaction, the stability will be more. So the most stable compound is which one is that toluene. When you compare all these four, you can see that toluene is the most stable compound because of it can make 9 hyperconjugative interactions, and here it is 6, and here it is 3, and the least stable on the basis of hyperconjugation interaction is tertiary butyl benzene. Okay, and of course we can see that by hyperconjugation we can see that the ortho and para positions, that means as I told you, here it is H. Okay, this bond comes here, so then what will happen? This bond is coming to this carbon, so what is that? Here you are getting a pair of electron and a negative charge. Similarly, this position also, you will, in the second structure here you are getting a negative charge, in the third structure here you are getting a negative charge. That means ortho and para positions are negatively charged. Ortho and para positions are negatively charged by hyperconjugation. Therefore, compound can immediately react with the electrophiles. Okay, it can easily undergo electrophilic substitution. What do you mean by electrophilic substitution? What do you mean by electrophile? Positively charged species are known as electrophile. When a positive charged species is coming, easily it will go to ortho or para position, because ortho and para positions are negatively charged due to hyperconjugation interaction. Therefore, if a positively charged species comes, immediately it can attack ortho or para position. That means because of hyperconjugation, its reactivity will also increase towards electrophilic substitution reaction. So this is the comparison of the stability of and the reactivity of what is that toluene, ethyl benzene, isopropyl benzene, and tertiary butyl benzene on the basis of hyperconjugation interaction. Okay, thank you. We continue in the next class.